Accomplished in Sector 7, searching for suitable planet to begin the next mission.
Too big, too small, too hot, too cold, too many rings, not enough water, too much water, too green, not enough green, too... Hold on a second. What do we have here?
We have Earth, also known as Terra, third planet from the sun in the Milky Way galaxy, home to plants, animals, and millions of Earthling people, and one superpowered alien originally from planet Lexicon.
Really?
Name, WordGirl. She possesses super speed, super strength, and super vocabulary skills.
Battle record?
Undefeated. By teaming up with WordGirl, success of mission is guaranteed.
Ha ha! Perfect! Colonel! Set a course for planet Earth.
We would need the living dictionary. Her superior intellect keeps the prime world in check. Go, girl! Huggy faces by her side. Vocabulary a mile wide. She'll make sure that prime will pay to throw some mighty words your way. Word up, it's Word Girl. Word up! From the planet Lexicon.
Miss Power.
Today's featured words are harsh, vigor, encouraging, and ploy. Just another typical day in the life of Word Girl.
Done. No major crimes or catastrophes going on. Looks like the whole day is wide open.
Help! Help!
I did not jinx it.
Becky, if I can complete this puzzle within the next 15 minutes, I can win a year's supply of Snappy Snaps! You help me with this, I'll split the winnings with you 50-50.
Becky! I was just at Milo's Toy Emporium, and all pretty princess figurines are 75% off for the next 45 minutes.
Excuse me?
Yeah. And they had two Sparkle Toes left.
Sparkle Toes? Did you say Sparkle Toes?
Sparkle Toes.
Sparkle Toes is the hardest to find ever and almost completes my collection!
Oh, hey, Becky. Did I just hear that you're going to the toy store? You know, I was heading downtown, too. Maybe we could walk together and maybe get some ice cream or something.
Is this really happening? Sparkle Toes and ice cream with scoops? The most perfect day ever? Let me just say to all three of you, a great big Y-E! No! The police can handle it. I don't have to... Fine. Guys, I just remembered. I have a school thing. Come on, Bob.
School thing? But we're on vacation.
Vacation! V-A-C.
Moments later, in a heated battle with Dr. Two Brains.
It's been more than a few moments. I've already missed my dad's crossword deadline.
Rundle's over.
Ugh. And there goes the toy sale.
Hey, this is about me.
Right, sorry. I kind of lost some of my vigor for this battle. I mean, can we just get it over with already?
Oh, come on, Word Girl, get your head in the game. Dr. Two Brains, Cheese Rape, yoo-hoo! Look out behind you!
Seriously, Doc? Oh, huh. Will you look at that?
Greetings, people of Earth. My name is Miss Power. And this is my loyal sidekick, Colonel Gigglecheeks. We've come to Earth looking for you.
Really?
Yes, Earth's greatest champion. You've battled lots of evil and hideous... Is that a brain on the outside of your head?
Uh-huh, like it?
Yikes. Anyway, where was I? Oh, yes! Word Girl, Earth's greatest champion.
Oh, well, I'm flattered, but I'm not sure I'm the greatest. Maybe top 10.
And modest. Oh, this is going to be fun.
What is?
Why, training you, of course. You could definitely use some help.
Okay, a little less flattered.
No, I didn't mean to be discouraging. I meant to be more,
encouraging? You were trying to say it's great that I'm a crime fighter and also inspire me to work hard to be an even better one, right?
Yeah.
Like when a teacher encourages you to try your best on something you're having trouble with. Like, oh, I don't know, art or something.
Yeah, exactly. Look, it's just that I've been to hundreds of planets and thousands of galaxies and learned the most effective crime fighting techniques on each. And now, I want to train you.
Really?
I've used my knowledge to train some of the greatest champions of the universe. Maybe you've heard of a little someone by the name of Greg the Invincible, Nothing?
No.
He's amazing. It's a lot more impressive if you know him.
Help! The butcher is robbing the grocery store! Wait! Is this the police station?
No, this is the middle of the street. The police station is across town.
Oh, thanks. Help!
Why would he think?
It's kind of his thing. Don't ask. Well, listen, it's been really great to meet you, but I have a little something I have to take care of.
Mind if I tag along?
No?
Excellent. Come on, Gigglecheeks.
She put me on the spot. What was I supposed to say?
All right, I'm stopping.
Something wrong?
You know, I don't even know why I keep... Who's this?
I'm Miss Power!
Whoa, calm it down a bit there, lady.
Only if you calm down the smell a bit. Oof! You seriously run around town covered in meat?
I'm the butcher.
Ugh, more like the stinker.
I don't think I, You know, it's kind of a warm day, so...
Listen, I kind of like to stay away from the whole calling people mean names thing. Kind of makes me a little uncomfortable.
Oh, all right. Sorry, I'll just go stand over here and watch. You go ahead and do your thing, Word Girl.
Thanks.
Well, how about I do my thing, too? Kill Master Crusher!
Wait, not yet.
Hamburger Hurricane!
Huggy!
Not yet.
Pepperoni Prison!
Okay, now! Not only do you smell bad, you also stink as a villain.
You're a mean lady, you know that?
And you're just another captured criminal. Miss Power!
Ow! impressive.
Thank you.
Although, you know, the whole name-calling thing made me a little, well...
uncomfortable?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, you'll get used to that. Hey, I've got a great idea. How about I train you in crime-fighting techniques, and you train me in using my words more wisely?
Huh, now that's interesting. I mean, words are kind of my thing.
And I totally encourage that. If anyone's going to know the power of words, it's going to be you.
Right!
Now, I may not be as accomplished in that area as you, but I am a lover of words myself.
You are?
Yeah, and I got a thing for power. And what has more power than words?
Try nothing.
Right. And I love that.
Me too.
So what do you say? Would you like to learn what this old girl has to offer? And maybe teach her a few new tricks?
Yeah, that actually sounds pretty cool.
Oh, you've made me very happy. I just love to think that I can help someone make a difference while making myself a better person.
Hamburger!
So first thing tomorrow morning, meet at my ship?
Deal!
Excellent! See you then!
Power up and away!
I have a really good feeling about this!
Now, with WordGirl on your side, ploy to conquer Earth can be accomplished.
Ah, it's going to be so much fun! Giggle cheeks, we've found ourselves a new home.
What kind of ploy does Miss Power have in store for our plucky little heroine? I encourage you to stay tuned to find out on another suspenseful episode of Word Girl.
Word Girl!
Hear ye, hear ye! It's time again for the Pretty Princess and Magic Pony Power Hour. One day, the happy Sparkletopiopes were all happily happy, thanks to King Jubilance the Jolly. With his magic mood crown, he makes everyone in Sparkletopia as happy as he is. Which doesn't exactly make for the most exciting story. So, just then, the evil Count Cloudy suddenly soared into the castle.
All hail me, King Cloudy the First! Gloom!
Oh, what have you done?
I'm a storyteller. It's in my character to make things exciting.
I hate exciting.
Worry not, Sparkletopiopes! I, Pretty Princess, heir to the throne of Sparkletopia, shall rise to the occasion! I'll embark on a magical quest to retrieve my father's crown and return as a hero!
See? It's all gonna work out fine.
But, Princess...
And I shall bring a weapon. My Scepter of Smiles!
Ow!
Nothing will stand between me and my destiny!
You'll have to push.
Oh, this is great. We have a bad guy, a dangerous quest, and now a hero eager to prove her noble character.
Character?
A character, m'lady, is any person or animal in a story. But the word character can also mean personality. When I say you have a noble character, I mean you are a good and brave person.
Oh, I'm pretty too. Don't forget that.
Meanwhile...
Attention, subjects! Your mindless glee has come to an end!
What?
You there, furry blob! What know you of the whereabouts of Count Cloudy? Oh, so it's gonna be that way, is it? All right.
move this story along, shall we? I know. How about an exciting new character?
What? Nay, I say.
Will our heroic characters head for a new setting and escape the dragon? I don't know. Stay tuned.
Word Girl!
When we last saw Word Girl and Captain Huggy Face, they had come face to face with a new alien super being, Miss Power, who said she wants to share her amazing power secrets with Word Girl. But then later, back in her spaceship, she said this to her sidekick, Colonel Giggle Cheeks.
Oh, it's going to be so much fun.
Giggle Cheeks, we found ourselves a new home.
And that doesn't sound good.
Come on, Bob, hurry up! We don't want to be late for our first training session. Yeah, I didn't think I'd be this excited either, but what do you know?
Well, honey, I have to say, I'm pretty excited too. All you need is a dad, a daughter, and something fun to do.
Right, fun to do.
And we've got that fun thing.
Yes, of course, our fun dad-daughter thingy.
All right, so meet me here at the front door at exactly 2 o'clock. You got it, kiddo?
Got it, Daddo. I have no idea what he's talking about.
Not bad, kiddo. You're a quick study.
Thanks, and thanks for encouraging me.
Well, there's more to combat than just the physical. For example, how do you think I was able to beat the butcher so easily?
Well, by being stronger and faster than him?
No, well, yes, of course, but I was also able to find his weakness, one of his biggest fears.
He gets upset if people think he smells bad?
Exactly.
Yeah, using mean words to attack people isn't really my style. In fact, I thought I was going to help you use your words more wisely.
Yes, of course, absolutely, and we will get to that. But first, let me ask you a question. Do you think any of these criminals feel bad about constantly interrupting your life?
Well, no.
No. And do you think they care that you have to drop everything in your personal life to go and chase them around?
Well, no. Well, I never thought of it that way.
Well, you should start. Find their weakness. Take them down as quickly as possible and then get back to your life. Because it's hard to be a superhero and have a life.
Yeah, no one else gets that. Like yesterday, it was gonna be the most perfect day ever. Scoops, ice cream, and Sparkle Toes!
What?
Oh, Sparkle Toes is this pretty princess doll that's really hard to get. But the toy store had a couple left. And I was going to get one, but then I had to stop Dr. Two Brains from one of his cheese crimes and, I missed everything.
Uh-huh.
And like today, I'm supposed to go out with my dad later, but I'm afraid some...
Help! City Hall is about to be crushed! Wait, is this the police station?
Moments later...
Word Girl! So who's your new friend?
I'm Miss Power!
Wow, a little loud. Okay, well, I'm Chuck the Evil Sandwich Making Guy, and I was...
Chuck the Evil Sandwich Making Guy?
So anyway...
Okay, first of all, who is this clown, and what's up with his head? Is that a real sandwich?
Okay, that seemed a little,
Harsh. It means to be really, really cruel and mean.
Yeah, that was harsh.
Yeah, here's the thing, Miss Power. We don't really talk about Chuck's, he's a really sensitive guy.
Time out. Don't move. See, this is what I was talking about. This guy is kind of sensitive, right? Well, that's his weakness.
Yeah, I know, but it just seems so harsh to me.
Yeah, well, don't you think it was harsh of him to try to crush City Hall?
Well, yeah.
And don't you think it was harsh of him to waste your whole day with this nonsense?
Actually, yeah, that is pretty inconsiderate.
Hey, you think we can hurry this up? I have to get Sparkle Toes back home.
Sparkle Toes?
Yeah, I picked it up yesterday at this amazing toy sale. I grabbed it right before the sale ended. I'm surprised someone didn't snatch it up before me. I'm probably just gonna sell it, though.
Sell it?
Go on, Word Girl.
Yeah, I'm not really a fan. I don't get why people are buying this. I just know how valuable these are.
Go ahead.
That should be my Sparkle Toes. Mine! But because of you villains, I missed it. And now you have it! And you're going to sell it? You heartless criminal!
Yes, let it out.
Heartless? That's a little... what's the word?
I'm not telling you! I'm through helping you with words, you hear me? You'll have to figure it out by yourself, you big...
Good! Now finish him!
Big sandwich head! Whoa! I just... that was amazing!
Yes! Yes, it was!
My words, they felt so... powerful!
Yes! That's my point, kiddo! It's time you stopped thinking about other people's feelings and started worrying about your own.
I'm just so invigorated!
I can see that.
Help! Toby's robots are rampaging through the city! Wait, is this...
No, it isn't the police station. Look around you and use your brain. Ugh, so annoying.
Oh,
How'd you get in here?
I should go.
Well, is there something going on?
I don't know, something about Tony and robots.
Toby, that'd be Toby. We have to stop him.
Well, then by all means, let's keep it going.
Word up!
Power up and away!
Oh, this is just rich. Word Girl has herself a helper. Well, guess what? I have 12. Prepare to be.
Hi, Mrs. McAllister.
No, Mommy! I didn't do anything!
Mommy, classic.
Oh, ha-ha. Hilarious.
Yeah, you have a goofy haircut. And bad clothes, and you're afraid of your mommy. You're a ridiculous villain, Toby. You always have been.
Nice. Kapow.
That was rather harsh. I seem to have suddenly lost all my vigor for this fight.
Wow.
Right? They get so upset they just stop fighting. Isn't it amazing?
Yeah, I mean, I've always loved words, obviously. I guess I just never realized how powerful they could be, how upset they can make villains.
And then how easy it is to defeat them.
Right.
Yeah, well, speaking of powerful words, I hope you got some ready for your dad's apology, because it's 3:00.
What? No, I have to go.
Looks like it's just you and me, bad hair baby. Ha!
Dad, I'm so sorry. I had this thing I had to do, and I completely lost track of time.
Oh, it's okay. I'm just a little sad, that's all, and disappointed.
No, Dad!
I'm sorry I'm moping, Becky. I guess I was just, you know, I was really excited to see the world's largest bowl of applesauce together.
No, I know. Wait, what? That's what I rushed home for?
They say it's as big as a motorhome.
That sounds awful and boring. Not to be harsh or anything.
Oh. Okay. Sounded harsh to me.
What? Oh, hi, Mom. Big bowl of applesauce. I mean, come on. Well, yeah, I'm a little annoyed. I said I was sorry. Kind of. Great. So now I'm just supposed to let a crime happen because I snapped at my dad a little?
Becky, did you hear? The butcher is committing a crime, and Word Girl is nowhere to be found. Good thing Miss Power is on it.
Oh, right. Of course. Well, that's a relief.
Come on. They're showing it on TV.
Aw, what's wrong with this smelly, meaty baby, huh?
Where's Word Girl? She's not mean like you.
Wow.
I know.
What a story, folks. Miss Power taking down the butcher
and taking the city by storm. Excuse me, sir. What do you think of Miss Power?
Oh, I think she's great. Hey, that's a really ugly shirt you've got on, you know that?
Hey.
Wow, that seems a bit harsh, especially coming from someone wearing such ugly shoes.
Well,
I see what's going on, and I don't like it one bit.
Oh, come on, Mom.
This Miss Power is just bullying everyone.
But, Mom, they don't have feelings. They're villains.
But look at the effect she's having on the city. She's encouraging bullying behavior.
Mom, that's silly.
Yeah, Mom. I hate to agree with Becky, but you are so wrong. It's ridiculous.
Oh, don't give me that look. Mom is wrong. Miss Power is not bullying villains. Look, I don't care what you think, okay? Why would I listen to you anyway? You're just my sidekick. I need to take a walk.
Becky?
Becky, where are you going?
Becky? Becky?
Wait, what? What just...
Well, okay. So, is this the end of the defining duo, Word Girl and Captain Huggy Face? Or will they eventually talk it over and make up? Maybe? Please? Okay, so, I encourage you to tune in next time to find out, I know I will, on another scintillating episode of Word Girl!
Word Girl!
And now...
Predictions!
When last we left our courageous characters. Oh, okay. Magic Pony needed to think fast. So he reached for a handful of delicious wild berries.
What? Why?
It helps you think.
Are you making this up as you go along?
Indeed I am.
I do declare I'm as hungry as a horse.
Whoa! Hey!
What are you doing?
What are you doing?
Business.
A thousand pardons on behalf of my clumsy steed. We are searching for the king's mood crown, stolen by the evil Count Cloudy.
Cloudy?
Let me tell you where to find him. Head down to that dead-looking tickle tree over there. Take a left in the lollipop meadow. Keep going.
Oh.
Look straight up. You can't miss.
You are a kind and noble fruit. Come, Magic Pony, we must... Oh, dear.
We finally reached the setting for our story's danger-packed climax. A setting is a place where any part of a story happens. In this case, our setting is the base of Mount Cloudy. And at the top, Cloudy Cottage.
Yes!
Yes, Kitty Dewdrops, our moment has arrived.
What? Where's my wand? Where is it?
Hello, Count Cloudy. It's Pretty Princess.
I've come for my father's crown.
Nobody's home.
Please open the door, Count Cloudy.
No.
I'll be barging in now.
What will happen next?
Ah, how did you get in here?
Which character will prove triumphant? Find out when we return to this same setting for our thrilling conclusion.
Word Girl!
When we last saw Word Girl, she had hurt her father's feelings, broken off her partnership with Captain Huggy Face, and walked off without finishing her punishment chores. Word Girl had just started training under a new superhero named Miss Power, a mysterious alien with a mysterious ploy. She encouraged Word Girl to be harsher to her foes. So, was it a coincidence that WordGirl started acting funny at the same time she started training with Miss Power? Yeah, right.
So, my mom and Captain Huggy Face think that you've been bullying people, and now they think that I'm bullying people too.
That's ridiculous. Look, I know they mean well, but if anything, the villains are the ones doing the bullying, not us.
Right! Thank you! That's exactly what I said!
We're the good guys!
Yeah!
Fighting bad guys!
Yeah!
And we're the ones with all the power!
Right! Right!
So we get to do whatever we want, however we want, to whomever we want.
That's not really...
Help! Someone's robbing the... Never mind.
No, wait! What was that about someone robbing something?
Please don't yell at me.
I'm not going to yell at you.
But I am. If you don't stop whimpering and tell me right now what's going on.
What are you doing?
Getting information. What does it look like? Now spill it.
Someone's robbing the jewelry store. Please put me down. Thank you.
Next time, tell us quicker.
Help! Someone grabbed my sweatshirt!
Man, that guy is annoying.
Maybe, but he's also kind of helpful. And anyway, you can't just go around...
Come on, Word Girl, we've got a crime to stop. Power up and away!
Come on, hurry it up!
Let me guess. Stealing jewels to pay for your latest evil cheese-themed creation?
On the mouse's nose, kiddo.
Why don't you just use the jewels to buy cheese? You think someone with an extra brain would be a little smarter.
So how's it feel, Word Girl, huh? You learning all her bullying tricks?
No, she doesn't have any bullying tricks. We're the good guys. It's like she says, you're the villain.
Uh-huh. Enjoys bullying people. Got it.
I do not enjoy bullying people. I mean, I do not bully people.
Oh, no? Then why do you deny it with such vigor?
Vigor?
Yeah, it means with great strength or intensity. So when I yell, I do not bully people, I'm yelling with vigor.
Ooh, vigor, strength, power. I like that.
Yeah, you would.
Don't listen to this guy. He's not even a real villain.
Not even what? Not a real villain? Ha 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 ha! How's that for an evil laugh? Not only am I the real deal, sister, I'm the most dangerous villain in the whole city.
You? Please. You're not even in the top 10.
You have no idea.
Really? I have no idea. Well, tell me, Mouse Brains, how successful is this ploy so far? Huh?
All right, I'm captured. You made your point. You don't have to be so harsh. That's enough.
Enough? I'm just getting started. In fact, I'm going to make it my personal mission to make sure that you never get to eat another piece of cheese again.
No.
What?
No, you can't do that.
Oh, I can and I will. You and cheese, done. Finished. Finito.
Please. Please, no.
Okay, I think you're being a little mean, you know? Maybe taking this too far?
Too far? He's a criminal. There's no such thing as too far.
No. You see, it's...
Don't you have somewhere else to be?
Are you serious? We saved your precious little store. You should be thanking us.
Oh, no, don't worry about him. He can be a little cranky.
That's only because you let him. Me? Not so much.
Hey! Hey! Put me down!
Wait! What are you doing? He's just a regular citizen. You can't just...
Too late. Already did. Power up! Hey!
So, why is Reginald tied up like a criminal?
Well, because he's rude.
Yes. See, being rude isn't actually a crime. If it were, we'd send you to jail.
No one talks to me the way he did and gets away with it.
Listen, lady, you're going to let Reginald go.
Listen, Bosford, you better watch the way you talk to me.
Or what?
You'll have to deal with Miss Powell and Word Girl.
Wait, I never said...
You know what, Word Girl? I'm really disappointed in you because I know that you're a better person than this.
All right, enough of this garbage. You see, people like the Spotsford lady are the problem. They don't understand that you and I have the power. So that means we're always right.
No, we're not. In fact, sometimes we're completely wrong.
Excuse me?
Just because we have power doesn't mean we get to use it any way we want.
hello. That's exactly what it means.
No, it doesn't.
Well, since you put it like that. How dare you question me? I trained you. I'm Miss Power. Before me, you had a ton of trouble with all these second-rate villains. I encouraged you. I listened to your boring stories. I taught you how to be a decent superhero. Without me, you were nothing. And together, you and I were going to rule this planet in an awesome, we get to do whatever we want kind of way.
What? There's no way I'd ever do anything like that. Ever!
Yeah, well, I see that now. Looks like you were nothing but a waste of my time. Thought I could get you to team up with me. But, oh well. Guess I'll just have to take over this planet myself.
Yeah, I don't think so.
Ha! Like you're gonna stop me. You are nothing special. Just a silly little girl in a costume. You don't deserve to wear this. You see that, everyone? Word Girl is done. Finished. Defeated. Miss Power rules!
Huggy!
Yeah, I'm the best. Say who's the best said I'm the best. Yeah! And just in case there's any doubt whatsoever, I think it's time to bring Word Girl to jail. Why, that little sneak.
Thanks for coming back to save me. I'm really sorry. I should have never treated you that way. Oh. I know. It was like I was a different person. Mean, harsh, and I thought everyone else was wrong. So what do I do now? No, I can't. I can't go home. I don't think I could face Mom and Dad. Not after how I treated them.
I encourage you to go home and see your folks. Trust me, they love you. Unconditionally.
Hello? Anybody home?
Becky!
Sweetheart!
Oh. Mom? Dad? I know I said a lot of harsh things, and I wish I could take them back, but I can't. All I can say is that I'm really, really, really sorry. Can you forgive me?
Oh, honey, of course we can.
We were just so surprised. It was so unlike you.
Came out of nowhere. Blam!
Yeah, we've come to expect better of you. You've always treated others with respect.
But we knew you'd do the right thing and apologize. We love you, honey.
Thanks. I love you, too.
Hug. But don't get us wrong. You're still in trouble.
Big time.
Yeah, I was kind of hoping we could forget all that.
Yeah, not a chance.
Oh, I can't tell you how much better I feel. I've almost got my old vigor back.
Hello?
Miss Power?
Time to go to jail, District Attorney Botsford.
Jail? But on what charge?
Disagreeing with me.
What?
Now let's go.
What? You're not just harsh, lady. You're out of control.
Wrong. You need to be taught a lesson about who's really in charge. Me!
Hun! Hun! Time to spring into action! TJ.
Yes, sir.
Go around the house and collect these things.
Yes, sir.
And now, if you'll excuse me, it's time to put on my danger pants. Boop, doop, boop, boop, Tim Botsford.
Come on, Bob. I think it's time we taught Miss Power a lesson. She's more powerful than me. Hey, look, if you're trying to encourage me, you're not doing a great job. Wait, where are we going? Bob?
Miss Power's ploy revealed? Mrs. Botsford captured? Bob dragging Becky somewhere we hope is important? I vigorously encourage you to join us in a few minutes for the exciting, monumental, final showdown in yet another thrilling episode of Word Girl.
Word Girl!
And now,
Princess!
Okay, ready? Here it is. Our super cool, incredibly exciting showdown between good and evil.
You'll have to push.
You must surrender my father's mood crown, Count Cloudy! Nothing can distract us from...
Oh, no. Bad kitty two drops.
Your royal sparkleness, the scepter of smiles.
Oh, you mean this?
This could get any better. It's like, I don't know, if maybe the setting changed. They magically return to the royal court of King Jubilance. The setting where the story began.
Well, well, well. It seems your scepter has grinned its last.
Oh, yes. I fear your gloomy thoughts are now affecting even me.
But, Princess...
Fear not, old friend. Perhaps we've misjudged Count Cloudy's character. Perhaps he'll prove to be a great king. He does look quite regal in the crown.
Really? I thought it made my head look big. Anyway, you really think I could be a great king?
Yes.
Why, I've never felt so... I mean, nobody's ever said anything so nice to me before. What? No!
Actually, I think my father is doing a pretty good job already.
You've beaten Count Cloudy with kindness.
Oh, man, awesome! Everything's perfect in Sparkletopia once again. Except for that giant snarling dragon that just entered the hall.
What? Where did he?
Hey, don't look at me. You never got rid of him.
Yes, we did. We tangled him up in those trees.
No, you... Oh, wait, you're right. Anyway, it's kind of a cool twist, don't you think? Who's with me? Well, stay tuned.
When we last saw the Botsfords, they had just seen Miss Power take Mrs. Botsford away. To jail! Mr. Botsford and TJ immediately set a plan in motion to free Mrs. Botsford. While Bob seems to have a plan of his own, we hope.
What do you mean I'm not ready to face Miss Power yet? We have no choice. Patience? My mother is in jail! What is that? Super advanced secret battle moves of the planet Lexicon? What? How long have you known about this? This could have been useful, like, years ago. Oh, well, that's nice of you to say.
Mind translating that?
Oh, yeah, he thought I was doing all right on my own. Now that's encouraging. All right, then let's hurry up and start training.
Citizens of planet Earth, guess what? Someone new is in charge. Me.
Hey, what if we don't want you?
You get to go to jail.
Hey!
You guys aren't really smart enough to be running things on your own. You need a new leader. And guess who that is? I nominate me!
We don't need a new leader! We have WordGirl!
stop.
She can stop you!
No, she can't. I defeated WordGirl, and now this planet is mine. And if you don't like that, well, there's a nice cozy jail cell for you. Just ask District Attorney Botsford.
Okay, everybody. Here's the thing. We are in a prison. And there's no way that I'm spending the rest of my life here because some power-hungry alien decides she wants to take over the Earth.
Yeah, but what can we do?
This lady's even more powerful than WordGirl.
Hell yes.
Oh, I think I know a man with a plan. And a boy with a ploy.
Oh, is that one of those newfangled gadgets kids are always playing?
A ploy is a trick or a clever way of doing something.
Oh, you mean like when I pretend to be a harmless old lady just so I can fool some sucker I want to rob?
Exactly. That's a ploy you use.
Mm-hmm. We could use one of those right now.
Oh, yeah. But remember, I've got a couple of guys in my back pocket. But we don't have pockets because we're in jail. They don't let you have pockets because it might hold a weapon.
Meanwhile...
Ladder.
Check.
Grappling hook.
Check.
Flashlights.
Check.
Metal file.
Check.
Rock hammer.
Rock hammer. Check.
All right. Are you ready? Okay, sir. I am willing to trade my wife to get all of this cool stuff out of jail. I mean, trade all of this cool stuff to get my wife out of jail. I'm very nervous.
I'm sorry, sir, but it doesn't work like that.
Well, it has to work.
Sir, it's not going to work. Now get your stuff and get out of here.
Oh, fine. It's a no-go, honey. Repeat, Operation Trade Cool Stuff is a no-go. I did everything I could.
Oh, shoot. You know, I shouldn't have to encourage you. You're the most dangerous villains in the city. That's right. And you know, if you were all together, there's no way she'd be able to handle you.
Yeah!
And guess what you are right now?
All together!
All together!
Time to show this Miss Power why the rest of this city can't stand you guys! Okay, maybe I could have phrased that a little better.
I defeated her. And now this planet is fine.
Meanwhile...
Robots attack!
What?
Let's go get her! Charge!
Right. Bring it on! And my little student. Here to learn another lesson?
Okay, first of all, I'm not your student. The only thing you taught me was how to bully.
I tried to help you.
No, you tried to teach me to use words to hurt people, but that's just wrong. I shouldn't bully anyone, not even mean, nasty villains. No offense, villains.
None taken!
I have to set an example for others to follow. I wasn't born on this planet, but this is my home now. And if you think you're just going to come down here and take it over, well, you're gonna have to go through me to do it.
Okay. I think that was a ridiculously horrible speech, and I think your name should be Weak Girl, huh? Huh? Get it? Weak Girl.
Oh, you can be harsh all you want, but it's not going to work. No one here thinks you're funny.
I don't care what they think.
Of course you do. That's where you get all your power.
Oh, you found me out. I'm so weak. Well, except for my speed and strength. Ah!
Going to have to do better than that.
You don't have what it takes to be a superhero.
She does.
I think she does.
Yeah, she does.
You're right.
That's because you're all lousy villains.
There's the harsh again.
Yeah. Hey, no, they're not. They're actually really tough.
You're just saying that because it's true.
You're too small.
I'll grow.
You're too weak.
I'll get stronger.
You don't have the guts.
I'm here, aren't I? Here's the thing, Miss Power. You don't have any power over me.
Oh, yeah? Yeah? Well, I think you're a loser. I think you're a failure.
Really? Because from where I'm standing, it looks like I'm winning.
No, you're not. You're not. And I'll show you.
Like my new ploy? Huggy taught it to me. Here's how it goes. I don't accept your bullying behavior, and you lose all your power.
You're not going to win, because I always win, and I'm never wrong.
So you're saying that I'm going to be triumphant?
Yeah. Yes, that's right. You're going to be triumphant. Ha!
I think so, too. Know why? Because being triumphant actually means winning!
What? No, it doesn't.
Oh, yeah, it does. WordGirl taught me that just last week.
And that's the second ploy Huggy taught me. I got you to admit defeat using the power of words.
And she wasn't even harsh about it.
Yeah, that's showing them.
Not losing. I don't lose. If I quit, I don't lose. So there, can't beat me, won't beat me, never.
Yeah! And now, if you'll excuse me, I have a district attorney to bring home.
Yes, you do. See you later, WordGirl. And I just want to say that we all feel very lucky to have an arch enemy like you.
Aw, thanks. Goodbye!
Bye!
We're set then. Let's go on vacation, guys!
Hey, who wants a burger?
Cheeseburger!
Partay!
Flying is invigorating.
All right. Well, here you are, and I guess I should be, going.
I believe this belongs to you.
Where did you find it? Thank you.
And I sew. Well, Mr. Botsford sews. Do you need...
Nah, Huggy will sew it on later.
Listen, I know you're a superhero. And you probably get this all the time. But I just want you to know that I'm extremely proud of you.
Wow, thanks. I'm really sorry I let you down before.
Oh, apology accepted. Oh. You know... You remind me a lot of my own daughter.
Oh, you're, well, I...
Oh, well, not the whole costume thing or the superpower thing. More the vigor, the spirit, the spunk, the spark. I hope she grows up to be a lot like you.
Oh, I got something in my eye. Thanks, Mrs. Botsford. That means a lot to me. It means everything to me, Ma, Mrs. Botsford.
Okay. Bye, WordGirl. Bye, Huggy Muggy.
Honey!
Mom!
Mom!
We saw you on the news, fighting right alongside WordGirl. You were awesome!
Botsford family hug!
Group hug!
That's beautiful. And so, once again, truth, confidence, and family triumph over a villain's ploy. You see, all it takes is a little encouragement, a little vigor, and that bullying behavior loses all its power! Don't be afraid to join us again next time for another thrilling but shorter adventure of WordGirl!
Princess.
So, just to catch you up, everyone thought the story was completely over, but then... Whoa, but, in fact, our princess had nothing to fear.
Well, come on, people! Let's get funky!
Works for me!
And so, thanks to the heroic pretty princess, Sparkletopia was saved! Join us next time on the Pretty Princess and Magic Pony Power Hour!
Sparkle Hall!
Want more Word Girl? Watch your favorite episodes and test your word power on PBSKidsGo.org. Want Word Girl's word power? Fly over to your local library. Cape not required. Word!